was swimming in the pool with Firewall.
It's Bottles!
So, it's time to sign with our Vipers.
It's Tribbles! Zip! Abigail! Oh my god, Firewall's a three! Where the hell is Colossus? Am I right?
Still Wednesday, hey. My cool code talkers. Howdy, second upload of the day. Let's go, Gary's way.
Woo. So in case y'all miss it, we already uploaded today, as Logan just said. It is our second installment of Wild Card Wednesday, where we try to feature some of the content creators that we really enjoy and just bring a little bit more of a spotlight to them because we really enjoy them.
But that's not what we're talking about in this video, because we already did that video, so go watch that video. But today we're talking about Firewall, because guess what? Firewall is legal. He's back at three, but he's got a real ugly errata. But that doesn't mean he's useless. He still has a purpose in life. He is a snowflake with a place to be. What mountain is he going to fall on? I don't know. We're going to talk about some decks that he's good in still. Kind of. Maybe.
So for any of you guys who may be living under a rock, Konami decided that on April 14th, which is today, that Firewall Dragon is officially just off the ban list. It's free. You can just do whatever you want. I mean, thanks to Ghost from the Past. Shout out to Konami for releasing an alternate art, ghost rare, harder to pull version of Firewall Dragon. But yo, if you got your old ones, guess you get to play those today.
For those of you who don't know, we weren't around for Firewall for the first FTK round with that guy, because we came into the game in like literally December 2018. He came in December, I came in January of 2019. So we literally came in after Firewall was already banned and everyone lost their minds.
Yeah, it was literally like what, a couple weeks?
Yeah.
Like it might have honestly been like a week or two of the ban list, or like after that ban list.
Yeah, we missed all the hype. Everyone's always like, oh my god, I remember Firewall. And I'm like, well, I don't. So we didn't experience any of that deep-rooted trauma that everyone else seems to be talking about. The Goki FTKs, all the looping, whatever it was. We weren't around for it. So not that I'm mad about it, but at the same time, I kind of wish I understood where everyone was coming from. But at the same time, I'm glad we're at least in a period where, you know, he's back. And he's not the same, but he's back. So today we're going to talk about some of the top decks that can actually utilize the new errata Firewall at three in this format, or just in any format in the future, because we know some cards haven't come out yet. But we're going to talk about some cards that actually can use Firewall. So let's just get into it, shall we? But
before we get into this video, if you guys are not already a subscriber, feel free to go down, hit that subscribe button, throw this video a like, and comment in the comment section down below which Cyber stack you think is going to abuse Firewall the most.
We also have an Instagram. It's at CrushCardsYGO. We're on there all the time if you want to come interact with us a little bit more. We also have a super wholesome Discord community. It's absolutely bopping. If you want to do remote duel tourneys, dueling book tourneys, all sorts of fun stuff, come hang out with us on there. We're there all the time. And then last but not least, if you want to further support the channel, all of our shenanigans, we have a Patreon. The side decks go up on there, bloopers, all sorts of fun exclusive content. We have remote duel sessions with us. It's really great. I highly recommend you check it out. But if not, that's okay. We're just happy you're here to talk about Firewall. Also, make sure you have your listening ears on, because I will be announcing the giveaway winner from our OCG LOB opening from last week. So if you entered that giveaway, make sure you're listening, because we'll be announcing the winner in this video, and I want to give you your free stuff.
So this video feels a little strange for us to make, because as Logan said, we weren't around for Firewall, so like we literally didn't experience it. And like from our knowledge and just from like what people in our area have told us, it's kind of one of the reasons that, you know, like Armageddon Knight is at one, and just a lot of other cards are on the ban list. So for this like iconic monumental card to come off the ban list, and then like not even at one but at three, obviously it does have the errata. It's strange for us. Like we have no idea. But let's go through the errata and actually figure out what the card text is and what has changed on it, so we can further discuss the actual application.
How has he changed as a person?
Okay, so the errata says you can only use the effects of Firewall Dragon once per turn. So hard once per turn already. That's pretty darn good.
All across the board.
Once while face up on the field, quick effect, you can target monsters on the field and or the graveyards up to the monsters that this card is co-linked to and return them to the hand. If a monster this card points to is destroyed by battle or sent to the graveyard, you can special summon one Cybers monster from your hand. Alright, so the two big things from just reading this off the cuff is that it's only Cybers monsters you can special from your hand, so there goes the loops, my friend.
Yeah, and there's a lot of hard once per turn really reiterated on this card. It is like, you can do this one time!
Yeah.
One time!
And I feel like that is kind of what the card needed, and then the Cybers lock was just like the icing and on the cake.
Yeah, I think the problem before was, I mean, granted, we don't know, he was very generic, and that genericness made it really toxic, because decks could just really easily abuse this with other other generic cards.
So there are tons of Cybers decks out there, and that is going to be the topic of today's video, is some of the Cybers decks that can use this card and maybe even potentially abuse it. It's really also good to note that Cybers is like a brand new type, if not the most recent typing in Yu-Gi-Oh! To get support, and it's probably just going to get more and more and more, seeing as how it's new and still kind of evolving.
I mean, Konami keeps releasing set with new Cybers archetypes. Like, I mean, we just got the Live Twin Evil Twins, which are purely Cybers archetypes. So Konami is clearly not letting it go. So I think it was a wise thing on their part to let Firewall come back, but be specific to Cybers, because it gives that little edge to Cybers decks that maybe aren't the best right now, because, you know, Rogue, like, you know, we've got Salad, we've got Evil Twin, we've got Marunsus, I guess.
Yeah, we got
lots of decks that are, like, in the Rogue tier, but, you know, they just need something, and Firewall could potentially help the decks out, but I don't know. Are they? We're gonna talk about it.
So yesterday on the YouTube community page, we actually put up a poll asking all of you guys what you thought some of these Cybers archetypes were that could abuse Firewall the most. Mm-hmm. At the time of recording this, there is a tie for fifth mm-hmm. place, and it is currently between Mathmech and Marincest. Now, that being said, I am gonna vote, and I'm just gonna put Marincest in number five, because Marincest just kind of locks you into water.
Lock you into water, team.
You're not really making this dark Cybers type Firewall dragon. Yeah, it's a Cybers.
Yeah, make him turn one, unfortunately.
Yeah, you're not making... This is not an extender that you're making turn one and being able to set up some cool interactions. This is a turn three, turn four, you're out of resources and you're really scratching at the, you know, scratching the chalkboard to find something.
It's also unfortunate that the community page doesn't let me put six options. I wanted to put the Evil Twin Live Twins on there. So for everyone who said the Live Twin Evil Twins, I know those also could be used, but we'll just put them in an honorary, like, 4.5 space. So that puts it number four, which was technically tied. We put Mathmech for number four. Now Mathmech, I feel like, have been under the radar literally since their release in what was it? Think about Mystic Fighters?
Mystic Fighters.
It's been a hot minute. They're very expensive. The prices are starting to creep up more and more.
Starting to go. Rares are like $8. It's crazy.
They were very short printed as well. Some of the main deck monsters, is it Edition?
Edition.
I can't remember.
Edition
is extremely short printed.
We opened a case and I don't believe we saw Edition once.
Yeah.
Which is nuts.
So Mathmech are one of those decks that fly under the radar. Final Sigma is insane. Like,
yeah, cards are nuts.
Some Virtual World decks are playing Final Sigma now. He's a, was he a Synchro 11? 12?
Yeah, Synchro 12.
Oh my god, it's insane. It's a crazy good deck. The majority of the Mathmech cards are Cyber, so this kind of just provides as a potential extender for them, because, I mean, they clearly do enough on their own, but Firewall is just kind of there as an extra piece to help extend more when needed.
And if not, it's also just an additional form of interruption by giving you that quick effect. Mm-hmm. So moving right along into number three, it's our favorite Salad Boys, and by favorite, we mean the deck that we cannot stand.
I mean, it's not even like, sorry, all my Salad players, don't freak out. It's not even that we can't stand it anymore. Honestly, I'm indifferent at this point. I don't even care. Like, Salads are whatever. They're doing their thing. It's okay. I'm not mad about it anymore because I don't really play against it ever. Because, like, it's just a rogue deck at this point. It was frustrating when it was meta, but now it's not. So it's okay. We're getting
there. It's just that year and a half long PTSD.
Yeah. But, I mean, I guess we all, well, I guess you all experienced that with Firewall anyway, so I guess we all have our PTSD in different forms with different decks.
Salad is one of those decks that just has a recursive engine and everything is just like super easy to access. So Firewall, in my personal opinion, I'm not a Salad player, but like it kind of just feels like a win more card in the deck.
Yeah.
And it just feels like overkill. Like, I feel like if you're making Firewall Dragon, you're just extending too far. You could really just make like access code for
Games. And that's kind of where I was going to say too, and I do know a couple Salad players mentioned this as well. Like, if you're going into a Link 4 in Salad, you're just going to go into access code.
Yeah.
Like, I don't see Firewall being super viable because Salad doesn't need it, honestly. Salad can put four bodies on board and link climb with nobody's business. I don't think Firewall is something they even need. It's kind of like a utility card if you really need it, but I do not see it being necessary at all in Salad. Boy howdy, surprise! Welcome to the giveaway section of the video that we totally aren't filming last at the end of the video because we almost forgot, but we're gonna announce the giveaway winner from our OCG LOB opening from last week. We got a ton of comments from you guys and they were all super duper sweet. We asked you guys what your favorite boss monster was and we had a lot of beautiful comments. I love reading all your guys' favorite boss monsters. And if you like these giveaways, feel free to let us know because we do them all the time
and we
love doing them for you. And we will be doing one for Ghosts from the Past tomorrow. So if you want to win some Ghosts from the Past, come back tomorrow. But with that being said, the winner for the giveaway from the Orica Shop official giveaway is Nemo003. I love you. You're perfect. You always leave really nice comments. And you said Doom King is obviously your favorite boss monster because Zombies is the best deck.
And it's the best boss monster ever printed out of a structure deck. Easily. Hands down, Conductor's not even a competition.
Relentless. But Nemo, you're the winner. We love you. You've been supporting us for so long, and I feel like it's about dang time. Oh, so you know what, Nemo? This one's for you, babe. Make sure you message us on Discord or Instagram or however you can get a hold of us so we can send your stuff to you. But make sure you guys come back for tomorrow's giveaway for Ghosts from the Past and stick around for more wonderful content because we're here, so make sure you subscribe. But anyway, let's get back into whatever number we're doing now. Woo! So for the number two slot, you guys actually voted at Ignister. This was my personal first place vote.
Me too.
But like, I understand why it came in second as well. Regardless, it's extremely powerful, but it's going to get even more powerful because the support comes out in Lightning Overdrive that actually makes this deck absolutely bonkers.
Crazy. And if you have not gotten your pre-orders for Lightning Overdrive, feel free to head on in the links in the description box down below. Mm-hmm. Big3Deals.com, you can get all of your sealed product. Everything that is on its way out now, they have it up for pre-order. You mm-hmm. want Megatons? They got it. You want Lightning Overdrive? They got it. You want King's Court? They got it. Everything coming out in the next couple months,
it's yours.
Big 3 Deal already has it. Feel free to use the discount code CRUSHCARDS5. You get 5% off your entire purchase and it's shipping and tax included. Like, literally some of the most competitive market prices. You can't beat it. You really almost can't beat it.
So. And it's for the US and Canada, so feel free. If you're our Canadian friends, we got you. Adagnister is another archetype that's kind of been like sleeper for a long time. And like, it's a really good deck. Like, it's good now. It's just not like seeing a lot of play. But with Lightning Overdrive and the support, the deck is crazy.
They literally get their own Striker Dragon. Like, they get a link, it searches a field spell, and then summons not a hard one's return. Like, the card is insane.
It is so crazy. The deck just spams bodies.
It's nuts.
Like, for free. Yeah. For free. It can go into Firewall, no question.
No problem.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Yeah. Let's go.
Almost the entire deck is like a one card combo to get to like five interruptions. It's really, really ridiculous.
It is bonkers. Adding Mister is so cool. I'm really contemplating learning the deck. We got all the cards to learn it because obviously we're going to do a deck profile when Lightning Overdrive comes out. But the deck is just super strong, and I think Firewall is a really viable card in that deck because, well, you get there so easy.
Super easy.
And again, I feel like Firewall at this point, the purpose is not to like FTK anymore because you really can't. But I feel like it's more of just an extension piece.
And that brings us into our number one, or your number one pick, which was the Code Talker strategy, mm-hmm. which we found actually really interesting, only because we are not really super familiar with the Code Talkers. I know kind of what the line of play does. How's kind of like a one and a half, two card combo to get to like a pretty extensive board. Obviously Firewall will help that. So I guess I'm really interested to see what the deck can do, and it's maybe something we're gonna have to look into. So keep an eye out on the channel. Maybe you'll see a deck profile for that real soon.
And I know a lot of people are thinking about this deck in consideration with the OCG card Decode Talker Heat Soul, which we do not have yet, and I pray to God we actually do get in the TCG sometime soon.
We don't have a release date for that yet.
No, which is, you know, that's predictable TCG, you know, being its usual way. But I think we will get that card eventually imported, which would be really cool. Maybe we'll get it in the Megatons. Who knows? Ooh, I don't know. It'd be really nice.
Ooh. Promo!
Not even a promo, just in the set somewhere. I don't know. But regardless, even just Code Talkers on their own without Heat Soul, like, it literally was made for this deck. Again, it's a brains deck. Like, Decode Talker, the deck, is literally just Link Climb for days. It's for days. You can get to Firewall. Again, no
Super
problem.
Easily.
Because it's a link-based deck, the whole point of the deck is to just link climb.
And the best part about the actual like Code Talker strategy, at least from our perspective, is that it's almost all common cards, if not all common cards. So the deck is super budget.
And the thing that's nice with the Code Talkers as well is that Firewall is just 2+ effect monsters. So if you have links, it's just like so easy to get into. So I think that's another really nice thing with these link-based decks. So those are your picks for the best decks that can use Firewall now that he is at 3 with an errata. So don't get mad at us if you don't like this ranking. This was your
choice.
You did this. So if you want us to do another kind of video where we talk more about the decks that can use Firewall or just Firewall in general or like any of the profiles for these decks, let us know in the comments if you'd be interested. We're doing Adagnister anyway. If you want to see Code Talkers, if you want to see Dr. Marinsas, if you want to see MathMex, if you want to see anything else, let us know. We'll do it. But that's all we got for today. We will see you guys tomorrow for Ghosts from the Past. Your butt better be here at 9 a.m. tomorrow for a giveaway in Ghosts from the Past. We're going to be doing a lot of it, so make sure you're sticking around. We're going to do a buttload of openings and a case on probably Monday. So we'll see you then. We love you. You matter. And I hope you guys have a wacky Wednesday, my wonderful weeby firewalls. None of that made sense, but we're going to leave now. Bye!
See ya!